हेलो फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक्स फॉर बीइंग हियर इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डिसीजेस ऑफ टोमेटो। फर्स्ट डिसीज दैट इज अर्ली ब्लाइट ऑफ टोमेटो, दैट इज कॉज्ड बाय अल्टरनेरिया सोलानी। इट इज द कॉजल ऑर्गेनिज्म फॉर अर्ली ब्लाइट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द सिम्टम्स। First symptom, small, isolated, scattered pale brown spots on the leaf. The occurrence of spots on the different plant parts, that includes leaf, fruits and stems also. Second symptom, fully developed spots are irregular, brown to dark brown in color and with concentric rings inside the spot. This symptom is characteristics for the early blight disease that is caused by Alternaria solani. Whenever we study the Alternaria disease in that crop, and the same disease produces the concentric rings, that's why it is called as the characteristic symptom for Alternaria solani or disease caused by Alternaria pathogen. Next symptom, spots coalesce to form large patches resulting in the leaf blight. Coalesce means the adjacent spot come together and become larger one, that is called coalesion. Next symptom, lowest leaves are attacked first and the disease progress upwards. Means at the stage of initially while disease development, the lower leaves attacked by the pathogen, and thereafter the upward leaves may be infected. Means this disease spreads from the bottom of the plant towards the apex. In severe attack, the entire plant may be defoliated, means shedding of leaves may occur in severe infection of the pathogen or disease. Zonate lesions may also develop on stem and petioles, which break at the point of infection. Brown spots are also seen on calyx, slightly dark, sunken, round to irregular lesions on fruit at the calyx end. Sunken spot means the spots having the deep notch, that is called sunken spot. Let we discuss about the disease cycle. Primary source of infection, mycelium or conidia in infected plant debris, that is the primary source of infection. So we can judge here, if the primary source of infection is by means of mycelium or conidia in infected plant debris, then we must keep our orchard or keep our field disease free by collecting and destroying the stubbles from the field. Second point, secondary source of infection, that is conidia dispersed by wind, water and rain splashes. Epidemiology. Epidemic means what? Sudden outbreak and spread of the disease, that is called epidemic, and study of that factors called as epidemiology. Here we discuss about the factors, that is dry warm weather alternating with the intermittent rains. Second factor is reduction in plant vigor and senescence. Let we discuss the management practices to tackle this one, Alternaria. First one, maintain proper vigor of the plant, use of disease free seeds, removal and burning of diseased crop debris, spraying of mancozeb at the rate 0.25% or chlorothalonil at the rate 0.2% or zinep at the rate 0.25% spray at intervals. Second disease of tomato, that is tomato spotted wilt. It is caused by tomato spotted wilt virus. Symptoms vary among host and in a single host species. First, that is stunting, is a common symptom of tomato spotted wilt virus infection. Chlorotic or necrotic rings form on the leaf of many infected hosts. Chlorotic means what? Loss of chlorophyll from that part, that is called chlorotic lesions or rings. And necrosis means what? It is the death. Necrotic tissue means death of that tissue, that is called necrosis. Next, pale red or yellow areas with concentric circular marking in the normal red skin of ripe tomato are next, discoloration of seed means loss of original color of that seed due to the infection of this virus. Thickening of veins and bronzing of young leaves. Growing tips may die back and terminal branches may be streaked. Affected plants may have a one-sided growth, may be entirely stunted and have dropping leaves, suggesting a wilt. Mode of spread and survival. This point is also called as perpetuation. First, thrips are responsible to carry viral particles from infested area to non-infested area or from infected plant to healthy plant or not infected plant. Adult thrips transmit the disease only when the larvae acquire the virus from infected plants. Collateral host. The role of collateral host is also very important as it spreads or gives the chance to that pathogen to survive for a longer period. Following are the different host range. Next, the management practices. Removal and destruction of infected plants and weed host. Remember one thing, whenever we discuss about the viral diseases, some common management practices are there which are applicable for each and every viral diseases. In that, first one is removal and destruction of infected plant and weed host. Second, vector control with dimethoate or methyl dimeton at 10 days interval. As the thrips is the dispersing agent or virus particles are spread by the thrips, then it is very necessary to manage thrips by adopting the spray of any systemic insecticide or pesticide. Growing Crotalaria jonesi as a barrier crop reduces vector migration. Spraying of sorghum or coconut leaf extract, it is very beneficial and effective. Next disease, that is tomato mosaic virus. It is the causal organism for tomato mosaic disease. Symptoms: the virus causes a light and dark green mosaic mottle with raised dark green area and distorted crinkled younger leaves. The plant are stunted and leaves may be distorted to a fan leaf or tendril like. Distortion means what? It is nothing but the loss of its original shape and size, that is called distortion. The symptoms vary depending on the strain of the virus. Means if the strain of the virus changes, then the slightly there will be a change in the exhibition of symptom. Some strains cause yellowing or leaf mottling, which may also affect the fruit. Some other strains produce streak symptoms consisting of longitudinal necrotic streaks on stem or petioles. Such diseased plants are killed, means ultimately the plant will get killed because there is a infection in severe form. Necrotic sunken lesions also appear on fruits, and sometimes internal necrosis or browning of mature fruit occurs. Necrotic means the death of the tissue, that is called necrosis. Mode of spread and survival, that is perpetuation. The virus is seed-borne and is sap transmissible. The virus is spread easily by man and implements in cultural operations or by animals and by leaf contact. Let me see the management practices. As we know, all the viral diseases are having the common management practices. We see point wise, all collateral host in the vicinity should be destroyed before planting new crop. Rogue out and destroy diseased plants means roguing out the diseased plant from the field immediately after observation. If there is an incidence or some symptoms observed on the plant, then that plant or that plant part should be immediately eradicated from the field. Virus-free seed should be obtained and used for sowing. Soak the seeds in 10% trisodium orthophosphate for 15 to 20 minutes prior to sowing gives better result. Heat treatment for 2 to 4 days at 70 degrees Celsius. Crop rotation of tomato seedlings by inoculating with mild strain. Field workers should avoid using tobacco products while working in the field. These are the common management practices. By adopting these management practices, we can easily tackle the problem of tomato mosaic virus. Thank you.